You know, there's someone I'd like you to meet. Hang on. Is Mr. Morgan in?
Mr. Morgan left for dinner.
He left? Huh. Carl, you hungry?
Manuscript? Yeah, I'm sure they FedExed you a manuscript. They want to see that you can read an unpublished work and give insightful criticism.
Oh.
Read it twice if you have to. This is a big step in your career.
Yeah, I gotta go.
Hey, what about lunch?
I gotta go. We should be able to get across right through here.
It's a dead end.
Oh, no. I thought...
You thought? We're gonna die in the dark. I knew it. We're gonna die.
Get a hold of yourself!
These seats unbelievable or what?
Now, where's the sunblock?
Yeah.
25? You don't have anything higher?
What are you, Mercury? Thus ends the great Ballman experiment.
Maybe I need someone who doesn't speak English.
Yeah, how about a mute?
A mute would be good.
Ah, where are you going to meet a mute?
This is what my life has come to, trying to meet a mute. And Shlomo, you're the best truck driver.
I don't know if I'm the best.
Oh, you're very good.
Let's say good.
Okay, good.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Peterman Reality Tour.
Turn music off.
Hey, man, can we just go?
And go we will.
What is this? It's a pound cake.
Well, we have a bonus ultra-reality stop today. We're going to be hauling muffin stumps to the local repository.
We're going to a garbage dump?
And we're off.
Where do you think you're going?
Well, I was going to dump this.
Doesn't look like garbage.
Well, it's muffin stumps.
Where are the muffin tops?
This is a garbage dump. Just let me dump it.
Can't do it.
Is this a joke?
That's what I like to know about it.
Hey, look, you walk in this city, you gotta expect things are gonna stick to your foot. You hop in your car and ping, condom.
That doesn't explain the lipstick on the dashboard. Here, take a few shirts.
What?
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Kramer, but we can't get your car now. The keys seem to have been misplaced. Wait.
Negative? Oh, my God. Oh, why? Why? What? Date negative's good? Oh, yes, of course. How stupid of me. Thank you very much. What was I worried about?
I'm going to have to take a biopsy on this.
A what?
A biopsy.
A biopsy?
Yes.
Cancer? Is it cancer? Do I have cancer?
Well, I don't know what it is.
So you're talking...
About... No. We're not talking. We're just... talking.
So you need me to get fired.
We didn't say that.
No, we couldn't say that. Because even if we did...
We couldn't say that we said it.
You see what we're saying?
You are still paying for this lunch.
We didn't say that.
Jerry. I can't get fired.
Hey, bodysuit man. So, hey, bodysuit man.
What was that?
I think there's a mental hospital near here.
Yeah, very near.
Oh, hey, bodysuit man.
Hey. Hey, look
at that. Bodysuit man. Oh, hey, bodysuit man.
Hey. Hey, look
at that. Bodysuit man.
Forget it.
Okay, Newman's postal route is around here somewhere.
Who's Newman? Who cares?
Hey, Faye Peterman, let me off. I'm nauseous.
Can I have his caddy, Bob?
Yeah, everyone just settle down.
Okay, we got 3 hours left on this thing, and I can't drive and argue with you rubes all at the same time?
I think it's gonna be okay. That girl just smiled at me.
Maybe because she knows you're going to jail.
Hey, isn't that Willie, my dry cleaner?
Where?
He just went in.
No, I think he was wearing my houndstooth jacket.
What would he be doing wearing your jacket?
I'm Jerry Seinfeld. I tell jokes for a living. But there's no joking about the financial crisis here at PBS.
I must have had at least 8 in my mouth. I couldn't talk. I couldn't talk.
Why'd you have to eat so many?
Because they're juji fruit. I like them.
Welcome to a taping of the new show, Jerry. Does everybody here know what a pilot is?
Yeah, he flies the plane.
No, a pilot is the taping of a show that's the first show before a TV series. And this show will air on Thursday.
I've never been to the hospital a day of my life. Except when I had my tonsils out. You know, they never gave me any ice cream. I always felt that if they...
Shut up!
My God, George.
I slipped on the invitations. Where's the towels?
They're back on the rack.
Even with the two of us.
I think we're still a man short.
Hello?
You have 57 messages. Message 1. Message 2. Message 3.
Hey, it's George. Listen, I...
Message 4.
Raymer. Hello? I think Gammy might be dying. Yep. Okay, goodbye, Bobby. Don't call anymore. I'm dead now. Gotta go. 911. Don't go, Daddy. Don't go.
Now, Porter. You know your mother and I love you very much. But sometimes people fall out of love.
Just take the field on a beautiful afternoon.
It's hot.
Hey, Bobby.
I have some good juice.
Huh? After Paul O'Neill hits his first home run.
Yeah, Bobby.
911.
All right, hang on, Gammy. You're gonna make it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm sorry to bother you. I just want you to know that it took a lot of guts to come out the way you did, and that you've inspired me to do the same, even though that may mean a discharge from the service. Thanks. Anything wrong with it? 6:30, Scott. Time for your sponge bath.
6:30 already? I fell asleep.
Let me help you off with that. Here, I'll just slip it over your head.
Yeah.
Water's nice and warm, isn't it?
Oh, that feels really good.
George, are you telling me the truth? George, I'm talking to you!
You'll see. Things will be different now if you just give me one more chance.
Listen. I gotta think about this.
All right, but I'm serious about this.
All right, hand it over, man.
That's why men hunt and women nest.
He's got a gun! I'll
have a Brutski, Charlie.
Name's Mitch.
Yeah, there's nothing like a cold one after a long day, huh? Oh, yeah. You know, I've been known to drink a beer or two. But then again, I've been known to do a lot of things.
That's a shame.
What, are you sticking it to me?
What?
I think you're sticking it to me.
Oh, I'm sure George is just being sympathetic.
Sticking it!
Look, I'm telling you, I didn't do anything wrong.
That guy owes me $240.
Hey, listen, pal, you're in big trouble.
She's giving me her telephone number. Uma, Jerry. Uma.
Uma Thurman? Really?
Yeah.
How'd you manage that?
Yeah, well, I don't have any time to talk now.
He's got the Kevorka.
Well, maybe they're done with it. I could go pick it up.
I don't think so. It doesn't work that way.
Bill, how's your weekend?
Oh, excellent weekend. What about your weekend?
Fine weekend.
Yeah, good weekend.
Went up to the Cape, took the kids sailing. Lisa was a little scared at first. That kid's going to be a good sailor someday.
Oh, she's going to be a fine sailor.
I'm sorry, excuse me one second. Hello?
Hi, would you be interested in switching over to TMI long distance service?
Oh, gee, I can't talk right now. Why don't you give me your home number and I'll call you later?
Well, I'm sorry, we're not allowed to do that.
Oh, I guess you don't want people calling you at home.
No.
Well, now you know how I feel.
You got a sign for it.
Oh, right.
Hey, how about those Knicks, huh?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Quiet, shh. Don't say anything.
What's going on?
Hey, Kramer, I saw you going there. I'm not leaving you. Give me that jacket. Open up, Kramer!
What you coming here for?
Well, I thought I'd throw him off. See, he knows where I live.
Look, Kramer, I have to return this test. I've got to get out of here.
Well, I thought you took the test.
I have to take it again.
How come?
What's the difference?
Well, you can't leave now.
What?
Come on, Kramer! I want that jacket back! Never!
Excuse me. Are you eating a muffin top?
Yeah, a muffin top store just opened up down the street.
A muffin top store?
What did I just say?
So you broke the news to Mr. Costanza. Would you tell the court, please, what his reaction was?
I would describe it as restrained jubilation.
Murderer!
He killed our daughter! He knew those envelopes were toxic!
Put her in this court!
Why'd you do it?
I mean, I'll sleep in my car if I have to.
I'll die out here.
He was down there. Once he passed his front bumper, it's no longer his space.
No, it doesn't matter. He was...
Well, I think we need more special days at the stadium. You know, like Joe Pepitone Day.
Mm-hmm.
Or John Voight Day.
John Voight. The actor?
I make a motion that... We have no more of these meetings that have been initiated by George Costanza.
I suppose if I had suggested Liam Neeson Day, you'd all be patting me on the back.
Well, I felt bad about this afternoon, so I got you something.
Oh, you did? Do you guys all know Jerry? Hi, Jerry.
Yeah. Hi. Hi, Winona. Nice to see you again.
Elaine, is it your birthday?
No.
I don't need a reason to give gifts. It's my nature. I love to make people happy.
Here, you call him right now, okay? See if he's sniffing right now.
Good idea.
Prophet and Goldstein.
Yes, I'd like to speak with Barry Prophet, please.
I'm sorry, he's out of town this week.
Out of town?
Yes, he went to South America.
South America? South America. I'll call back, thank you. He went to South America.
Yeah!
You want to hit fools more. They fooled me, Jerry. You see the difference?
I'm not going to say it like that.
Just a suggestion.
All right, everybody. Take a five.
Yeah, that's five.
Let me see what I can do.
Oh, no. Buckles? You're not putting him on tonight, are you?
No. He hangs around in case somebody drops out.
Hi. I haven't eaten in 3 days. I was wondering how much longer it would be till I get my x-ray.
We'll call you.
Okay, question number 8. What if I told you my fiancé left me for another man? Does that make me more likable, less likable, as likable? Let's start over here this time.
More. Less.
I think you may have overcharged this. What is this?
That's the extra toast. Get it?
Got it. Did you just see what happened here?
What?
Did you see the way she pointed at the check? She gave me the finger.
That's how waitress types express derision. They don't want to get their mouths dirty.
Hey, everybody, here come the runners.
Excuse me. So, you and Roxanne are hitting it off, huh?
Oh, I wouldn't quite say that.
Really? From a distance, you seem to be coming on to her.
Oh, I'm a guy. It always looks like that.
I'm late, man. I'm in the race.
Go ahead.
Thank you, Jerry. A wonderful driver. Fantastic route, man.
All right, go. It's a race. Come on.
I got a key made for you.
George, I can't move in with you.
What?
I'm sorry, but I'm taking Neil to a clinic in England.
No, you can't leave me. Marry me. I'll burn myself. I'll burn my parents.
Sorry, George.
George. I win.
Here, I got it. Catch.
Hey, driver's license. How are you? Hi, Steve. How are you?
Hey, let's go get some coffee.
Oh, that'd be
great idea.
I've got to go down to the corner, but
it's... Oh, Paul, could you hold that door?
Hi, Jerry.
Hi, Joan.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
It's pretty good, not great.
Okay, great.
Are you happy?
Oh, I'm delighted.
Okay, have a nice day.
You too.
Hi, Jerry.
Can you get that, please?
Oh, sure. Where's Glenn? You're the woman from the street, and I am so sorry. You know, I'm not really a homewrecker. I thought he was a superhero, I swear. Lady, I'm not his wife. I'm his welfare caseworker. Is he home?
This is his home?
Yes. So he's poor.
I think this will burn.
What are we doing in this alley, anyway?
It's a surprise.
Oh. What are you doing? What is that?
It's a bag of donuts.
It's garbage.
No. When they make the new ones, the old ones come out right here.
All right, that's it. How do you spell your last name?
It's a bear claw.
You have no idea how rare this is.
I'll make it out to cash. How about $200? $250? Make it $300.
You know, Elaine, you're the bear claw in the garbage bag of my life.
Oh, Glenn.
There's just one more thing.
There it comes.
You forgot to sign your check.
Sorry. You sure there isn't anything else?
No.
So that's it?
Unless you need a receipt.
I wish that was all I needed. Life can be so confusing. I'm searching for answers anywhere.
Good luck with that.
Did I? Oh, a TV? A stereo?
Yeah, and I got you a cord of wood so you won't have to burn them.
Oh, my God, Allison. You're home early.
Who is this?
His wife.
You're poor and married.
Looks like it.
Who the hell are you?
I guess I'm Lois Lone.
Wait a second, Turbo. I didn't have a Turbo.
You caused that a Turbo?
No, it's a 900S. It's a Turbo, Elaine. A Turbo!
Turbo! Excuse me, did you say Turbo? Saab Turbo 9000? Is it Midnight Blue?
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, Black Saab. Looks like that building cut you off. See you around.
At least it is.
Jackass!
Do you think you'll ever find her again?
Oh, I sure hope so.
Boy, how about when Harrison Ford jumped out of that plane and he was shooting back at them as he was falling?
What about the underwater escape?
Oh, man!